Hi, boys and girls. We're going to be doing an awesome project today, making our own salt dough clay. And when we're making this today, you're going to be able to use that clay to create your own dog design. Now, you can also make other animals too, but we're going to start off with a simple dog design. Before we get started, you're going to need a parent or an older sibling to help you do this. So let's get started with finding out what ingredients you will need to start your salt dough clay project. Let me slide our dog out of the way and slide in our ingredients. So here we go, guys. To make your salt dough clay puppy, you will need the following supplies. You will need a half a cup of all-purpose flour. You will need 1/4 cup of table salt, the kind that you eat. You will also need 1/4 cup of water. Flour, salt, and water. When you're finished with your project and it has had time to dry, you may want to have paint or markers to add color to your design. All right, I'll let you gather these things and we'll get started. Okay, here we go. Our first piece that we're going to need is we're going to need a bowl to mix our components in. You will need, your first ingredient will need to be some all-purpose flour. It can be any kind of flour. And you, for this project, you will need 1/2 cup of that flour. Make sure you only fill your cup to the top when you're measuring your ingredients. There's your flour. All right. Now we will need 1/4 cup of table salt. Any kind of salt will do that you can get from your grocery store. This would be the kind your mom or dad cook with. And you need to make sure you only have 1/2 cup when you're pouring it in. All right, and leveling it off, shake a little bit, and there you go. The next thing that you will need is 1/4 cup of water. Now, it's better to have less water than too much water. So make sure you save a little bit for the side and only put that 1/4 cup in. If your ingredients are a little dry, you can add more water as needed. Okay, to do this, you will need to mix your ingredients. I have a spatula, but you could use a spoon or something like that from your kitchen. And you want to slowly and gently mix your ingredients together. Okay, just slowly do this. Now, if your parents or siblings know anything about making dough or biscuits or things like that that you would normally eat, it's kind of the same consistency you're looking for. You don't want it to be too liquidous or to be too dry. So you have to make sure that you have just the right amount of moisture, water, in your design, in your ingredients so that your clay turns out just right. Now I want to give you a warning. This clay that we are making from things from the kitchen is not something that you would want to eat. Do not eat this clay that we are making. It would be very salty and it's not good for you. This is only for the purposes of making art. Now, as I'm mixing, my clay is kind of breaking up. So that's telling me, my clay is telling me that I need a little more water. It's a little dry still. So I'm going to come over and add just another drizzle of water. Not too much. It's better to add some instead of having to take things away. It's hard to take it away. So we only want to add just a little bit of water at a time and keep mixing. Turn your bowl. Your mom or dad or whoever's helping you do this could help you with the mixing of the clay. You want it to mix well, but you don't want it to be crumbly or have dry spots in it. So once I have my clay kind of mixed, and it's not breaking apart anymore. It's staying together. It's not sticking to my spatula. It's not sticking to my bowl. It's nice and smooth like that. That's telling me I'm getting where I need to be with my clay. All right, so this clay can be used for all kinds of art projects. Remember, it dries in the air, so if you leave it out overnight, it'll dry and you can use it that way after you've made things that you want to keep. If you have parts that you would like to save for a second art project, you can put it in a Ziploc bag and put it in the refrigerator and it'll keep. Okay, so you don't have to use it all at one time. All right, so my clay now, you can see, is firm and it's sticking together and it's not cracking and falling apart. So it's telling me it's ready. All right. When you start to work on your project, you want to have a surface that your clay will not stick to, and you can dump it right out on your table, okay? All right, if you need to do a little more mixing, you can roll it in your hands, press it, get it warm like you would normally get clay warm in class if we were working on a clay project. Make it pliable, make sure all your ingredients are nicely mixed. It should not stick to your hands. It should not be cracking and falling apart. All right, so I'm gonna take away some of my clay and I'm going to make a little ball out of it for the face of my dog. Now, before I get started, make sure this is big enough. I'm going to roll my clay around, flatten it out on my surface that won't stick. Try to make it about the same thickness all the way through. And what I mean by that is try to make it the same distance all the way through on your place that you're pressing it on. Don't press too hard. You want to be able to pick it up, okay? I cut a piece of paper out for the size of my face that I'm going to be making. So I need to reshape my clay a little bit. You can do that with just a scrap of paper. You know, you always save your scraps of paper. And your dog's face could be any size you wanted it to be. Then you could use something like a skewer or a popsicle stick or something like that to cut around the outside of your clay to get your face shape. Okay. Try to keep it neat. Save your scraps. You may need them later for parts. And then you can pull off your shape. All right, now I'm going to keep my water near me, and I can use my finger and get a little bit of water on my finger, just softly dip it in and use it to smooth down my edges, just like we would use water in class to help us smooth down our clay if we have rust spots like where we were cutting. Okay. All right, I think that'll do. I'm going to pull off my face. And I'm gonna put my face where I want it to stay, to dry. I'm gonna put it on a paper plate. And that process, you may need to reshape a little bit, that's fine. All right, so we know when we look at our puppy, we need maybe some ears. So I'm gonna take a piece of my clay and shape it into a puppy shape, like a puppy ear, maybe press my finger down in the middle, okay? And if you have an old brush, like an old toothbrush that you don't use, not one that you would use for your teeth, maybe one you would use for cleaning, you can scrub that with a little water on the end of it and attach it to where you want it to be on your head. Press it down, do your shaping, okay? Not a lot of water, just a little. And now I need two ears, so I'm going to shape out my second ear. Try to make it about the same size. If you need to add a little more clay, you can do that. All right, and then I'm going to put a little bit of water there with my brush. Put down my second ear. Shape it up. You guys are going to take your time and do a good job. Kind of make your clay stick together with its parts. You can shape up your ears a little more after you get them in place. Use your fingers. Maybe use your popsicle stick or some things you can find around the house to help you with your molding. Okay? All right. Now, dogs have different parts to their eyes. So we're going to take a small piece, make it round by rolling it into a ball in your hand. You're going to decide where you want your eye to go and push it down just a little bit with your finger, dampening it a little bit with your water. Then we're going to add a second eye. Get the little eye about the same size. Press a little water there and press it down to it's almost the same size as your other eye. If you want your dog to be winking, you can make one a little smaller if you'd like. All right, so these are going to be our eyes. Next, we're going to add the colored part of his eye. So I'm going to make an even smaller little clay ball to go right in the middle. And I'm going to sit that right in the center. And I'm going to make one for the opposite side. Sit it right down the middle. And to make sure that it sticks, I'm going to use my round stick and I'm going to press a hole all the way through. Slide it out. And now you have your pupil, the hole, your iris, the round circle, and then the white of his eye. So that's how you make that. All right, now he needs his muzzle. His muzzle's gonna have his nose and his cheeks, his whiskers, and his tongue. All right, so to start the muzzle, I'm gonna make a small ball. Rub that with a little water and put a nice little ball there. A dog's muzzle is made of circles. A long snout. All right, I'm gonna make another size ball. Scrub it with a little water. Press that out. Try to get it even if you can. If not, don't worry about it. So now we have a place for his whiskers. Now he needs a nose and a tongue. All right, so my nose, I'm going to make this into a circle and then shape it into a kind of triangle shape and put it right up there, press it down. And the last part I'm gonna do is my dog's tongue, okay? So I need a little piece of clay. I'm gonna kind of roll that around and then roll it out a little bit like a long tongue and press it right in the middle. Maybe use my stick to help me make the little crease in his tongue. Press down the nose a little bit. All right, and then he needs a place for whiskers. Did you know whiskers grow straight in a row on a dog and a cat and things that have whiskers? They sure do. Check it out. All right, once you're finished with all your details in your face of your puppy and you've neatened up your edges, you can do that. Let this dry overnight. And after it dries, it'll get hard, okay? Air dry. And then you can add color. Now I use paint to add color to my dog, but you could use markers or anything. But the paint is what I seem to think that works best. All right, guys, have fun making your pups and or other animals that you decide to make. And remember, save your leftover clay in a little plastic baggie in the refrigerator and you can have fun making another project. All right, till next time, you guys stay safe.